Today, I'm going to be showing you my 4.5 million coin FIFA 21 team. FIFA 21 is here. Don't waste your money on FIFA points. Go to MMOPO.com and get cheap, fast, and safe FIFA 21 coins. Use code OZNOZ to get 8% off your order. Link in the description. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another video. Now, in today's video, I'm going to be basically flexing a little bit on you guys, showing you my 4.5 million coin squad builder. If you do enjoy it, it'd mean the world if you could drop a like. And most importantly, if you want daily FIFA 21 content, please subscribe. We're trying to hit 17,000 by the end of the year, and we're very, very close to doing it. So please drop a sub and the notification bell turned on for very regular FIFA 21 content. Another little thing for you, if you guys want to comment down below how much money you think I've spent to get this team, how many pounds, and if you get it very close, I'll give some of you some FIFA points. Today, I'm going to be taking you through the team, the custom tactics, the formation, the player instructions, everything you need to know about my team. And yeah, I'm excited. Let's do it. Starting in goal with Marc-Andre ter Stegen. A very solid keeper. I got this guy in a two-player pack very early in the game. He's untradeable. He's first owner. So this guy should be my keeper for a very long time unless I get an upgrade in some sort of untradeable pack. Very, very solid. I found him to be very good. Of all the other keepers I've used, he seems to be the best. And he's one of the highest rated, if not the second highest rated goalkeeper in the game. Fantastic. Played 161 games with him already. So solid and really good kicking and distribution, which I found very OP, especially as I sometimes spray it onto the wings. It's very good. Now, at right back, we have the new Mukiele. Obviously, this is an objectives card, so it's technically free. I reckon if it was on the market, it'd be valued at something like 100k. That's what all the OP right backs are priced at the moment, 100, 150. So I put him at that price, but very solid card so far. The great thing about this card is I can use it in many different ways. I can use him at right back, as he is in my team now. I can switch him to centre back if I need to at any point. And another great thing is as a person on the bench, if I wanted to put on the bench, I can use him as a right back, a centre back, or even a CDM as a substitution. Very solid, massive, fast, and very OP. Next to him, this is going to be a bit of a surprise. I have so many coins, such a good team, but I've chosen to use an 82 rated centre back. This guy, in my opinion, is so, so overpowered. I had to use him. I genuinely think he's on a par with Varane. I've used both of them. Hernandez is so big, so powerful. He's only 6 foot, but his presence is massive. He intercepts everything. And in my recent weekend league, he was the star player. Not even exaggerating. What a player. Now, matching him is going to be Longley. I got this guy in my starter packs of FIFA, so I've played 160 games with him. Him and ter Stegen have been a little pairing that I've kept throughout the game, because obviously they're both from Barcelona. Very solid, very fast, very strong, and his defending and interceptions are absolutely fantastic. Moving on to left back, the most OP, best, unreal left back in the game, Mendy. Get him if you can. He will save you wins. Incredible player, so good, fast, great attacking. He's 4-star, 5-star on a defender is ludicrous. He is the player you want. And yeah, just absolutely fantastic. Now, moving on to next player. Now, it's come as Timo Werner. Timo Werner is my striker in this formation. We're playing a 4-2-3-1. He's my striker. He has to be in this order due to chemistry. But I've had this guy from quite near the beginning. I bought him when he was just his 85. Obviously, he's got upgrade to 86. I love this guy. I'm a Chelsea fan. So it's fantastic to have a Chelsea player that's meta enough to use. His skill moves of 3-star. Sometimes are a bit annoying, and his 71 passing can be very frustrating. But what I've learned to do is I've learned to make it so I don't have to do any extraordinary passing with him. He plays up top. He doesn't play on either of the cams or central cam. So he's just excellent. And his record of 90 games with 80 goals and 41 assists, all in foot champs or Division 1 or Division 2 rivals, is a very, very good record. Moving on to our first centre mid, another Chelsea player, N'Golo Kante. Incredible player. Just very OP in every single FIFA. Fast, great defending, everything you need to know. And his pairing, oh no, this isn't his pairing. This is actually our left attacking mid, Mbappe, one of the best players in the entire game. Fast, good at shooting, good at dribbling. I don't need to tell you about Mbappe. He is incredible. Bought for 1.4 million. I think he goes for a bit more now. so it's pretty decent. But he plays at left attacking mid for me, and he is so, so OP. He basically gets a goal contribution every single game, and this is just in champs and a couple of rival games, so it's very impressive. Moving on to our right wing, or right attacking mid, Mo Salah. I packed this guy as well. Goes for about 350-400k, so as you can tell, my pack luck is pretty decent, if I do say so myself. He's probably the least clinical of our front four. He basically just always gets the assists and sometimes the finishing goals when the opposition defender tired. 4-star skill is great, and his 3-star weak foot's a bit of an issue, but if you just bang everything on his left, he doesn't miss when he cuts in on his left, so it's all good there. Moving on to our other centre mid, very similar to Kante. I'd recommend this guy, not his one to watch because obviously it's a bit expensive, but if you don't have a lot of coins and you're looking for a great midfielder, this is the guy. He's so, so, so good. Fast, good at defending, physical, great dribbling. Everything is immaculate on this guy, and he's 4-star skill moves, which is lovely for a centre mid. Him and Kante are one of, if not the best centre mid pairings you can find on the game. Last player in the team is going to be Neymar da Silva Santos Jr. What a player. 5-star. This guy is so elite. I cannot even begin to tell you. First of all, look at his stats. 122 games played, 160 goals, 124 assists. Now, I think about maybe 50 of those, if you knock off 50 of each of the goals and assists, I think they came from some squad battles games that I was doing for objectives. Apart from that, he is ridiculous. I play him at CAM in the 4-2-3-1. He is the best player in the team by far at CAM. The CAM position in that formation was made for him. So this is the team as it kind of goes into a game. But what I'll show you is the custom tactics and the way it kind of lays out in general. So I go for a 4-2-3-1. I press after possession loss, very OP, width bang in the middle, depth at 4. Then I have a really fast build-up, which is important because my front four players are very fast, creative, great finishing, weak foot skills. So it's great to have a fast build-up where you penetrate the opposition's defense. And especially if we're pressing after possession loss, we get the ball and then we want to absolutely counter him so he has no chance. Fast build-up. Then we have width in the middle, and then players in the box. Just one more than normal, just because when I have someone like Mbappe running down the wing, I want Werner and Neymar and your boy Mo Salah to get in the box, get on the end of the cross. Corners, 3, and then free kicks, 2, because you don't really need players in the box for free kicks because I normally just shoot. Formation, I see 4-2-3-1. We have Kante and Allen CDM, and then Mbappe, Neymar, and Salah behind Timo Werner up front. Instructions, I have my strikers stay central, get in behind, and stay forward. Neymar is just stay forward, everything else normal. Salah is stay forward and everything else normal. And then Mbappe is stay forward, but get into the box for the cross because I think he has the good little... If you do that, then Mbappe is based like a second striker slash lamb. And then these two are just cover center and stay back while attacking. And the entire defense is stay back while attacking. So that overall is my team. Again, let me know down below what your predictions, how much I spent on this team are. Make sure you subscribe, like if you enjoyed the video and you found it interesting. And yeah, let me know any improvements you think I could do. And I'll see you guys next time.